safety behind the cross. Instead of me trying to engage him in warfare, because there are some levels of warfare that I cannot contend with by myself. Oh, God, help me. So I must get behind the cross of Christ and begin to plead the blood of Jesus. Because when I begin to think that I can handle these situations on my own accord, that's when the enemy has me. That's when the enemy will trip me up. When I begin to think that I have a powerful prayer life, that I'm a mighty man of God, that I'm a mighty warrior in the kingdom, but I must forget that all my help comes from the Lord. All of my strength comes from the Lord. I don't care how bad it gets. Know that the enemy is trying to destroy you because of the promise that God has made in your life, or made to you in the seed of destiny. Touch your neighbor and say, I'm on my way somewhere. Oh God, you old saints used to say, I'm on my way to the seed, that I'm on my way of the king's highway. Well, we don't sing no songs like that anymore. But I heard the old songwriter say that I'm climbing up the mountain. Y'all ain't gonna help me. I'm trying to reach the top. But what the songwriter didn't add in is that I go to the top, there are going to be some difficulties in my climbing and my ascending to the next level of ministry. Somebody might be saying, well, I'm not a minister. Yes, you are, baby. At the moment you accepted Jesus Christ, we all become ministers of the gospel. You don't need papers and a turnaround collar to tell your neighbor that Jesus saves to the utmost from the government. God, you hear me? You don't need a paper to go and tell the crack addict that there is deliverance from this crack. You don't need a turnaround collar to tell some young woman standing on the street corner that there is a better way. The enemy wants to keep you locked up and confused. He wants to keep your mind stayed on the situation instead of you activating your wonder twin power. And do not the old saints say, I keep my mind stayed on Jesus. Just another day that the Lord has kept me. He has kept me from all evil. I'm a preacher anyway, Bishop. With my mind stayed on Jesus. What's so important about my mind? My mind is the enemy's playground. So therefore, I must come back here in my mind. That's what Paul said in Romans 12. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy. Somebody ought to cry holy. Oh, you want to cry holy. Holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. But he goes on a little further. He tells us we must be transformed by the renewing of our mind. How do I transform my mind? In the word. Joshua 1 and 8 says, if I meditate therein day and night, y'all ain't gonna help me. What did Paul say? Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, you ain't going crazy. But if you don't get in the word, the enemy will make you crazy. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, church that talk to each other. Neighbor, you've been wrestling in your mind over your purpose, over your destiny, and your adversary as a roaring lion. He's been watching how the saints handle their what they call you. There's my baby. Touch your name and say, First Lady Jones is here. Hallelujah. He's gonna watch you how you handle your trouble in your home. Touch your name and say, neighbor, don't let the enemy have you down to a science. Hallelujah. Grab your neighbor by the hand and say, you got to switch on it.